Perry Lakes Reserve is managed by the town of Cambridge in Perth, Western Australia. It's one of the major assets of the town, located 7 kilometers west of Perth's CBD in the suburb of Floreat. The reserve covers an area of 80 hectares and includes Perry Lakes Parkland, 57 hectares, East Lake and West Lake of 13 hectares, and the Otterbury Reserve of 10 hectares. Perry Lakes Reserve is particularly valuable, being adjacent to Bode Park, with 437 hectares, the largest remaining remnant bushland in the urban area of the Swan Coastal Plain. Perry Lakes has an interesting history. Aboriginals originally camped at the lake, where they hunted and fished. There's an Aboriginal heritage site declared for the area. Near Perry Lakes is Rehoboth Hill, and this area was originally known as Lime Kilns Estate, where quarrying and lime building works was established by Henry Trigg in the early 1800s. In 1844, he established an abattoir and holding yards for stock, driving cattle from the north, almost 400 kilometers from Geraldton. A tannery was built and many subsidiary activities were developed in the activities. The lakes and surrounding land became known as Padbury's Paddock. After 25 years, Padbury sold to the Birch brothers, who in turn sold to Joseph Perry in 1879. Joseph Perry, an illiterate herdsman employed by Perth City Council, proved an astute businessman. He dealt entirely in livestock and fenced the area extensively. This was the end of the road for many animals which were farmed near Geraldton and mustered down the old North Road for slaughter. The North Road was the stock route established when the city ran out of grazing land and Geraldton were settled. This continued well into the 1930s, with many of the animals being taken to Robb's Jetty for slaughtering and live shipping. The area consisting of almost 1,300 acres was purchased from Joseph Perry by the Perth City Council in 1917, with Perry House built in 1919 to accommodate the caretaker of the endowment lands. Perry House exists today and is the headquarters for the Wildlife Society. The Empire Games, or Commonwealth Games, represented the burgeoning economy and significant metropolitan growth of Perth, which began to be inspired as a progressive modern city of international significance. A substantial number of architectural projects were undertaken, including the Beatty Park Aquatic Center, but also the Perry Lakes Games Village. The games were opened by Prince Phil, and with 30,000 people in attendance filling the stadium to capacity, they were an enormous success. They placed Perth and Western Australia firmly on the map. A competition was held for the design of the Games Village. The winning design shown here established a feature of many of Perth's suburban houses based on the garden concept. The unfortunate outcome of this is, of course, the vast spread of Perth, almost 200 kilometers in length, with unsustainable suburban sprawl. The houses were built by State Housing very cheaply, and when 5 years ago it was announced that they might be heritage listed, 120 of them were suddenly pulled down quite illegally. The stadium is still in use today and has very little change from 1962, but has been allowed to fall into gross disrepair. Its large size, seating 30,000, and antiquated resources makes it a white elephant. Nevertheless, it still gets widespread use by many groups, such as the Perry Lakes Hawks. However, the immense increase in land values has made the area tremendously valuable. Cambridge City, which inherited the land, desperately wants to sell it. Let's look at the dispute between the town of Cambridge and the state government, a fight which has not yet reached resolution. The town of Cambridge came into being in 1994 as an effort to revitalize local government. The original proposal was that the aging Perry Lake Stadium would be torn down to put in a residential development to pay for new sporting facilities to be built nearby in the AK Reserve. Many people were upset at the loss of Perry Lakes because of its sporting heritage with the 1962 Empire Games. But most people agree that it is way too large and is a white elephant and not meeting current needs. The renewal project was to build a much smaller stadium, maybe for 2,000 people, and smaller sporting complexes in the AK Reserve. However, this is still under dispute, particularly who's going to pay for them. The town of Cambridge feels that they should not have to wear the bill. The state government resumed Perry Lakes through a redevelopment bill in 2005. The new act has removed from Cambridge their important land asset. The AK Reserve is owned by the University of WA in most part. It's located very near the Perry Lake Stadium, directly to the southwest. Here's one proposed plan for the AK Reserve, but to date no construction has started and there is not even agreement on what will be built. Now join Mark Perry and myself as we explore Perry Lake in the second week of February 2007. We're trying to locate a geocache site near West Lake using a GPS. The area is still delightful for tourists and is very popular on a Sunday afternoon. Often this playground is teeming with young children. Well, we can't locate the geocache site, and even though there's lots of cricket games in process, cricket doesn't interest me, so we decide to watch the model airplane fly. There are some interesting looking spectators. Perry Lakes is well known to ornithologists because it's got many types of birds attracted by the marshlands and the water. Here's a listing of only a few. The grand opening of the skateboard park was only a couple years ago and excited a lot of attention. Thanks, dear viewer, for joining me on this tour of Perry Lakes, its history and use today. I wish you a very pleasant day.